Hello everyone, let's look at this basic trig equation here. And we are solving this equation on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, including the 0 but not including the 2 pi. And so what we are going to do is that we are going to use the reference angle approach for solving the equation. And you can also use a unit circle approach for finding the values for, in this case, what angle that you plug into the sine function will give you the 1/2. And if you can memorize the unit circle, then that will be good. That also works. But then reference angle only requires you to memorize the sine for the trig functions, whether you get a positive sine for a particular angle that you're plugging into the sine function, or are you going to get a negative sine? So what we are going to do right now is that we first just look at the value that we have on the right-hand side of the equation. And so for the right-hand side of this equation, as you can see here, that's 1/2, right? And so if you're using the reference angle approach, all we need to do is to draw a triangle. So how do we draw a triangle? We just draw a right triangle. So let me just make it an easy one here. So we can just draw a right triangle here. And what happened is that we are going to look at this angle here. This is the angle that we are looking at. Okay, so because this equation tells you that sine of x is equal to 1 over 2, and we all know that sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse, so we can just label the 1 on the opposite side of this angle that we have here, and then the hypotenuse, of course, would be the 2. And then usually we can just figure out this using the Pythagorean theorem, right? We can just do the square of the 2 and then minus the square of the 1, and then you can get this one. And of course, you're going to take the square root of that result of the subtraction. But right now, because usually we can actually memorize this right triangle here, then we don't actually need to do the calculation for that. So we know that this adjacent side for the angle will be square root of 3. And so in this case, we can we can see this is a 30, 60, 90 degree right triangle. And you may say, what are the angles? The angle that's facing the side, that's 1, that's the 30 degree angle here. So that's 30 degree here. And then what about the other one? The other one that's facing the square root of 3, that's the 60. Okay, so that one is 60. And then, of course, the one that's facing the hypotenuse is 90 degree. Okay, so what this triangle tells us is that we have our reference angle. Our reference angle is from here. So our reference angle, so we can just write it down. Our reference angle, because it's this angle that we're talking about, and we know that that's 30 degree, right? So we can just simply just put down 30 degree right here. So that's our reference angle. Okay, and then we also need to worry about the quadrant that we have here, because we are solving the equation on this interval from 0 to 2 pi. So in this case, we need to consider all four quadrants. And so if we are considering all four quadrants, we need to know where sine is positive, because it says sine of x is equal to positive 1 over 2. So where is sine positive? And then we are going to use this chart right here. This is a nice chart that we can use for determining whether sine is positive. So what we can do is that we can just draw the four quadrants in here. And what happened is that we can, if you remember this, that there's something that says, that tells us whether which quadrant that sine is positive in, or which quadrant that the other trig functions are positive in. And so what happens is that we'll just memorize it as all students. Actually, let me use a brighter color for this one. So it's all students, okay? So all students take calculus. And so from this chart, this actually means all the functions are positive in the first quadrant. This, in the second quadrant here, this S stands for the sine. So it tells you the sine and, of course, cosecant, which is the reciprocal of the sine, are positive. And then tangent and the cotangent are positive in the third quadrant. And then the cosine and the secant are positive in the fourth quadrant. So now we know that sine is in the second quadrant. And then, of course, sine is also positive in the first quadrant. So that means when we write down the quadrants, we are going to say that the angle must belong in the first quadrant because sine is positive in that first quadrant and also the second quadrant. And so this is actually all the information that we need to figure out the answer. And so from here, because we already have the reference angle, then we can write down our corresponding angles for the reference angle in the first quadrant and in the second quadrant. And so the solution to this equation would just be x equals, okay, so the we want an angle that's in the first quadrant with a reference angle of 30 degrees. That's actually the same thing, right? So we are going to just have the 30 degree here. And actually, because we are solving the equation and writing down the answer in radians, so we are not going to write down 30 degree right here. We are going to write pi over 6 right here. So that's the one that that's in the first quadrant. And actually, I'm just going to just write down the corresponding information beneath it. And so you can see that, okay, so pi over 6 is actually having a reference angle of 30 degree and it's in the first quadrant. What about the other one? The other one is going to be, the other one is in the second quadrant, and that one, it's 150 degree. Why do we get 150? Because if you just think about taking the 180 minus the reference angle, which will give you the 150. And for 150 degree, then you are going to get 5 pi over 6. And so that the angle in degree is 150 degree, of course, and that's in the second quadrant. And so basically, this is your solution to this equation. And then you may say, why do we only solve the equation from 0 to 2 pi? Because we are consider all the angles from 0 to 2 pi. That will satisfy this equation here. And once we figure those two solutions out, what we can do is we want to obtain all possible solutions for this equation without any restrictions. And all we need to do is to add 360 to get a coterminal angle of this angle. And then the same thing can be done for the other angle. Okay, so that's it for this problem. I'm going to do more complicated problem next time. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and give me some support. Thank you, and I will see you next time.